Welcome back to Attack on Tiny Titan.
Oh.
Because apparently that's what I look like right here. Okay,
I'll put my clothes back on. We were just teaching him how to do how the fat rolling and the stuff works. So
yeah.
He took off all her clothes so that...
it got hot in here.
And God was at a mistake. Yeah.
So that he could see what not...
Also, holy shit, I just noticed our souls count. Guess.
Fate of the undead, right?
Oh.
Well, you're not the first. But there's no salvation here. You'd have done better to rot in the undead
asylum. This is your... let's see, what is it now? Third episode? You're here,
let me help you.
Gosh, I guess it is already. Yeah. I feel like I've only been here for an hour, though.
I know, right? It feels so weird. Even though it's been days at a time now.
In the undead church. The other is far.
So one of the things that I really like about the Dark Souls and the Demon Souls games is exemplified by this guy's dialogue right here, where he talks about how you're this undead adventurer, but you're not the first. Lots have come before, they all failed. These games are very ambivalent to the presence of the player character.
That's true.
They treat you, at least at first, like you're nothing, you're insignificant, you're just going to fail just like everybody else does.
So I'm One Punch Man?
I suppose. I've never seen that.
I don't know. I don't really think they were... No, they never really treat him like he was going to fail.
And the reason for that is because these games aren't so much about the player character's journey. This isn't, you know, Skyrim, Rise of the Dragonborn. This is a game that is about... the lore that's about the world and its history, not so much the player character's history, which is why the player character doesn't even have a backstory.
Kinda, yes and no. I do want to interject on that slightly. The game is definitely about the player's journey, because, I mean, the game is actively following the player as they make the journey around the world. But everything you come across involves the world's story.
Right, but in terms of narrative structure, the narrative isn't about the player character. The narrative is just the narrative just uses the player character as a vessel to explore the history of the world.
That's true.
You know, this game doesn't have a story so much as it has a mythology.
Well, it has a history.
Right, and you uncover that. Yeah, you uncover that history and mythology piecemeal by, you know, encountering enemies and bosses, and by picking up items off the ground and reading their descriptions. If you go into your pause menu right now, John, or your equipment menu, go into equipment, left, L1. Yeah, go into there. And now press square on your Estus flask. Each item in the game has this little, you know, couple sentences.
Just a little tiny blurb that tells you something about the world.
And you piece together the mythology of the game, the story of the game, by reading all of that stuff.
I have a question.
Okay.
Why are there no rupees?
Good job. Because you're in the wrong game.
Yeah. Yeah, I said heavily inspired by Zelda, not Zelda clone.
Not actually Zelda.
Not actually Zelda. But now you're in the central hub area of the game, and you're allowed to pretty much explore in any direction that you want, even though I think 4 out of 5 of those directions will probably are the wrong way.
There's a lot of directions that'll lead you to death.
Yes.
Is this a mimic?
No, there are no mimics in this game. I promise you. Absolutely, positively, no mimics in this game. You should walk up to every chest and without hesitation open them.
Just thrust it open, yeah.
I got a morning star. Should I,
If you want. That's entirely up to you.
Too many options. Mm-hmm. Homeward Bone, what does that do?
Those are like a teleport trolls.
It takes you back to the last checkpoint that you were at, so that you don't have to risk dying and losing all your souls. Souls being experience.
So if you ever get in a really risky position, you can just...
Yeah, if you know that you're about to enter a boss room and you've got like 0 flasks and 2 hit points left, you use your Homeward Bone to go back to the bonfire
you can
and try
fuck
again.
Fuck this shit, I'm out. You know, just pop on home and heal and try it again.
Cracked red eye orb.
That's a PvP item, but since you're not online, you can't use that, unfortunately.
It's literally useless.
I'm going to be doing a lot of reading between episodes,
aren't
I? See,
that's fine, because this is a game that really encourages you to kind of learn at your own pace and like actually read and take the time.
And you are using the Morningstar.
Yes.
Yep.
Now, did you check the stats for the Morningstar?
Nope, I just thought it looked cool.
Okay. All right, well, there you go.
That's one way of playing, I guess. We'll see how far that takes him.
Can I drop down here?
You certainly can.
Ooh. You can drop down everywhere. There are also, just like there are no mimics, there are also no bottomless death pits in this game.
Oh, yeah.
Absolutely
no,
none.
Absolutely
you should jump into every hole that you find. They all lead to hidden treasures. Every one of them, I swear.
And by the way, your path you chose poorly.
Meh.
I would highly suggest not.
I think pretty much everybody who plays the game goes down into this cemetery pretty early and then gets promptly destroyed by these skeletons.
Immediately regrets it, yes, because these skeletons are unforgiving and
Hi.
A bunch of assholes, essentially. Oh, we're fat rolling.
And I'm trying to remember if these skeletons
keep
respawning unless you have a holy weapon.
I believe they continue respawning.
And he's going even deeper into the cemetery.
Oh, yeah, he's going.
Wait,
is there
a way out? Is there a right way to go?
the other way.
Okay.
Just keep going the way you're going. You're actually...
There's
items down here, and one of the things that you do in this game, so brutally hard, is you make suicide death runs for loot.
I died.
You did die, yes, and you lost your 666 souls.
No!
Unless you go back to the cemetery and pick them up again.
I'm going to go back to the cemetery.
Oh, okay. I would highly suggest taking off some of the stuff that you aren't using to not fat roll.
Well, if he's got the armor on, I mean, he doesn't have any armor to replace it with.
Yeah.
And he's not good enough at dodging yet.
But what I'm saying is, like, take off the other sword.
Which way did I go?
Oh, yeah, that's not a bad idea.
I'm carrying that sword, extra.
You have that sword.
Yes,
still
everything
equipped.
That is equipped on this screen has weight to it, except for the consumables and arrows.
Oh, okay. So I might as well take that off if I'm rolling around.
If you press triangle button. Press triangle button?
Here? Okay.
Yes, triangle button. So that shows your equip load there on the right hand side. If you're over 50% of the total, then you're going to do some variation of fat roll.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
And if you're fat rolling, it's you're going to have a bad time.
So that's not a fat roll. Which way did I go? Did I go
No,
this
that
way?
Is a fat roll.
We'll do it again.
Was it not 50%?
Was this the direction I went first?
Sort of.
You kind of, yeah. You went to where the guy in the blue was and went up the stairs.
Okay. Does this get me in the right direction? Does this get me back to the graveyard?
This might get you to... Sparkles.
A firebomb.
I mean, it'll get you somewhere.
Because, baby, you're a firebomb.
It may not be where you want to go, but... Firebombs do come in handy at points, but... Not particularly right here.
Blue guy. Where are you, blue guy?
You were going the right way. Turn around.
No, that's... Well, it's back to the cemetery. If he's looking for Petrus, then no, he's not. Going the right way.
No, he wants to go back and get his souls.
I want my 666 souls.
Yeah, okay, keep going this way.
Oh, actually, this is...
I don't remember going this way.
No, this is not the right way.
And that's because you took another route.
Yeah.
You took the shortcut underneath the elevator. But now, anyway, if you go back the way you came, through the pool, and then off to the right... To the right...
Oh...
Yeah,
there's a path there.
Yes, that right. Well done.
I'm not very good at finding paths. Hey, I fell
down
here.
Or at following directions, apparently.
Did I fall down here earlier? Yes, I did.
No, you didn't. But there's stuff here, so,
There's a guy.
Pick up the stuff. Good job. Yep. And notice the text here that says pillage corpses.
Yes.
Yeah.
You can't get through that way. Well done.
I was going to say, I was kind of worried. I'm like, well.
So even the act of looting bodies has kind of this morbid.
Yeah, it has a very negative connotation.
Yeah,
to it.
Undertone to it.
It's
like,
not. Yeah, it's not looting or taking a body. You're pillaging.
Right. I mean, it's not quite like the game tells you you're desecrating corpses. But it's like it's the next step down.
It doesn't say rape corpse.
Yeah,
right. You're not raping it. You're not desecrating.
It's not skull fuck the enemy.
Yeah. Well. Not yet, anyway.
Yeah. Well,
usually the skull fucking happens to you.
Yeah, I was going to say, usually it's the enemies doing that to you, not the other way around.
I picked up a humanity earlier. What does that mean?
So,
it doesn't surprise me that you don't know what humanity is, but...
That's good. I wasn't going to say
No, I'm kidding.
Oh, hey, guy.
Humanity is something in this game that basically revives you from being a zombie. I mean, I don't know if this qualifies as spoiler at this point.
Well, I mean, you don't have to talk about it from the story point. You just talk from a gameplay point. When you're human, you have more... I don't know if this is in one, but you have, a little more health.
No, not in the first game. One of my complaints with the first Dark Souls is that being in human form doesn't have as much of an advantage.
That's true. Because like, I think the only thing being human really gives is it allows you to interact with like the summoning side.
It lets you play, engage in the multiplayer.
Yeah. Otherwise, there's no real advantage. You can't even be, there's no invasion from the Hollow, is there?
No, you know what? I don't remember, because that has changed several times over the course of the game.
That's kind of changed.
I think the first Dark Souls, you could not be invaded when you were Hollow. In Dark Souls 2, I think you could, and then in Dark Souls 3, I think they've gone back to you can't.
I'm pretty sure you can't if you're unembered in 3.
Okay, I guess I don't care about those souls if I just killed those guys and got 110.
Yeah, really...
666 souls is not a lot of souls.
It's minimal. It's chump change.
And you're now actually going the way that you're supposed to be going.
You're actually going the recommended correct way.
Even though you're still having fireballs thrown at you.
Yeah, but I mean...
Anyway, what was I saying? Oh, yeah, so in Demon's Souls, they had the... It wasn't zombies in Demon's Souls. In Demon's Souls, it was like you're in a spirit soul form.
Yeah.
And when you were in the soul form, you had half of your max HP.
That's right.
But you also had certain perks for being in soul form, which was that you made less noise. So it was actually easier to sneak up on enemies. You couldn't get invaded. You couldn't do co-op. And when you beat a boss, you automatically were revived back to your human form. And at that point, you had your full health, and you could engage in all the multiplayer, and you could get invaded. Mm. The thing that I didn't like about the Demon's Souls system, though, was what would often happen is you'd beat a boss, right? You'd get revived, and then you'd take two steps into the next level and be pulverized.
Immediately be killed and lose.
And the very first level of Demon's Souls, the very first boss, is like a perfect example of that. You beat the Phalanx boss, which is basically the congratulations, you finished the tutorial part of the game. And then you take, like, you kill a couple little minor enemies, and then you take two steps out onto a bridge and get immolated by a dragon.
Oh, that's right, yeah. Or you run into the rolling skull.
Hi, giant rat.
Yeah, and you should kill the rat and pick up the goodies that's behind him.
You should definitely not let the rat touch you.
Now,
I mean, unless you're into that.
Now, I actually happen to think that Demon Souls is...
He's not dead. Oh, yes, he is.
I actually kind of like Demon Souls more than Dark Souls. You know, Demon Souls had a lot of problems with it. I mean, like, magic was kind of broken.
Was very broken, not from a technical standpoint, but from a gameplay point.
Right, you could start the game as the royalty class, which gave you the MP regen ring for free at the start of the game. And it was basically the game's undocumented easy mode, because you could just wait for all your MP to recharge and then just fire magic missiles at every enemy until they died. And then Demon's Souls also had, I think the other biggest problem was, at least outside of like PvP issues, which is a whole other bag of worms. The other biggest problem was probably that heavy armor was just garbage in Demon's Souls. Because in Demon's Souls, in addition to having the equipment burden, which made you fat roll, you also had an item burden, which was there was a maximum amount of weight that you could carry in your inventory at any given time.
Yeah.
And when you wore heavy armor, it didn't give you enough extra protection. Avoiding damage is always better than tanking through the damage. So it wasn't worth wearing the heavy armor in Demon's Souls, because it just slowed you down and made it so that you couldn't carry as much loot out of the level with you. Dark Souls fixed that problem by adding the poise mechanic, which makes it so that heavy armor actually allows you to tank through enemies' attacks.
Yeah, there was an actual advantage to heavy armor, which, to me, I liked, because whenever I played these kinds of games... Good job.
Yes. Well done.
That was very well done.
That is what the kick is for. Exactly. Congratulations.
I actually love playing the heavy armor, you know, two-handed weapon character, because that's just my playstyle, but it doesn't really work in this kind of game.
Right.
And heavy armor in general kind of isn't that good.
And in Demon's Souls...
In some situations.
Yeah, and in Demon's Souls, unless you were like a really good player, heavy armor and two-handed weapons was not very viable.
It was not a very good option.
Because you couldn't take anything else into the level with you, because you'd hit your item cap.
Yeah, you were already on the
and you wouldn't be able to pick up any of the loot that you find in the level, which would suck. So Dark Souls fixes that somewhat with the poise.
Yeah.
But then again, Dark Souls also doesn't have the item burden, so the heavy armor isn't as big of a disadvantage as it was in Demon's Souls.
But I mean, I think that was the right decision, too.
I'm kind of on the fence about it, because the one thing that I liked about the mechanic in Demon's Souls was that it gave you this, every time you went into a level in Demon's Souls, and Demon's Souls was more strictly segmented into levels.
Oh, hi!
Yeah. But he just wants to say hi, John.
You kind of, there's kind of this sense of preparing for it, right? You would go into your inventory, and you would take only the items that would be useful for that level.
But I mean, the problem with that system is you have to kind of know what you're doing ahead of time.
That's
true. Or you have to do a dry run and die to something.
That's true.
So
you have to
know what you're doing ahead of time.
You have to go into Valley of Defilement to find out how bad of a thing poison is before you know to equip your character with anti-poison stuff.
Yeah. Oh, I backed myself into a corner.
The disadvantage in Dark Souls is that you can carry everything with you. There's no reason in Dark Souls to ever drop any of your equipment off at the item boxes or whatever.
Well,
and so,
that's also because they changed the way that, you know, restoration items work in general. Like, the Estus...
Oh, I'm not even talking about restoration items. I'm talking about extra armor and
like
weapons.
I'm talking like that in general, though. Like, you didn't have to carry, you know, 99 half-moon grass or anything anymore. It was just, you had this one item.
Right, but the
it was essentially, as long as you had the one item, everything else was secondary.
True. But the point in... yeah, and that was one of the problems with Demon's Souls, was that you could tank through virtually any level by just farming enough grasses in advance. Yeah. Dark Souls also fixed that by giving you this more D&D-style Estus system, where you have a limited number of uses. So you never want to take damage in Dark Souls if you can avoid it, because...
It's more punishing than it was in Demon's Souls.
Right, in Demon's Souls you could always offset it by just farming more grass in advance. Whereas in Dark Souls, you can't. But,
it's essentially mash your face against the unstoppable wall.
Right, but the downside to not having an item burden is that you can carry everything that you collect in the game in your back pocket.
That's
right.
True.
So there's never any situation that you come across where it's like, oh, you remember that item that I collected way back when? That would be such a good item to have right now. I wish I'd brought it with me. No, it's just, it's right there.
Yeah, I mean, that's true that it does invoke a little more of, like, the fantasy-style element of, like, the role-playing, but at the same time, I don't know, there's hits and misses and advantages and disadvantages to it from a gameplay standpoint.
And it's a very subjective thing. Like, to me, I liked that sense in Demon's Souls of, if you want to heal, you actually need to rest at the bonfire.
Yeah.
Not just light it. But anyway, personally, I liked that sense in Demon's Souls of, you had to prepare.
Yeah.
For the place that you're going
to. How do I fill my Estus flask?
It does just when you sit down.
Yeah, when you're at the bonfire.
Well, I had 10. Now I have 7.
That's a game mechanic.
Yeah.
What that is the fire at the Firelink Shrine, which was the last one you rested at, has been kindled.
Yeah,
it has a
stronger strength.
It's a special fire. Okay.
Right, it's a stronger fire.
You have to look with your special eyes.
And you can spend humanity at a bonfire to kindle any bonfire and make it stronger. And the stronger you make it, the more flasks it gives you back when you rest at it.
Well, maybe we'll find more bonfires next time on the branch.
Next time on the branch.
Mmm, boy.